winning. I want to talk about how to get you out of your mind state, because in order to be successful in life, in order to be a winner, in order to be successful, you have to have a warrior's mind state. You have to have a warrior Spartan mind state. You have to be driven. Forget motivation. Motivation is only more material. Someone can motivate you. You go and you listen to a motivational speech. Like many of you listen to me right now, you might be motivated. Somebody comes along, you forget everything that was stated here. Lost the motivation. But if you're driven, you have that animalistic mentality. So you never want to be the lion that's on top of the hill. Because once you're on top of the hill, you become complacent, you become comfortable. And someone comes along and they knock you off because you're no longer driven. But you will always want to be that lion running up the hill. Why? Because that lion running up the hill always have a hunger for more. And he's going to destroy his prey. And forget what the herd is saying. If the herd is saying, hey, you should do it this way. Listen, man, it's better to run up the hill alone. It's better to walk alone in the right direction than to follow the herd in the wrong direction. See, winners are very ambitious and driven about what they want to accomplish. They don't take no for an answer. And self-motivation is key. Self-discipline is key. That's what keeps you going. That's how winning is done. So, now I'd miss more than, I'm gonna quote somebody. Now, I'm gonna wonder if you can figure out who this is. I'd miss more than 9,000 shots in my career, and I've lost more than 300 games, 26 times. I've been trusted to take the game-winning shot and miss. I fell over and over and over again in my life. And that is why I succeed. That was Michael Jordan. That's what Michael Jordan said. See, winners, it's the next thing I'm gonna say to you. Winners take responsibility. Winners don't make excuses. Winners hold themselves accountable for what happens in their lives and don't blame any external force or factor. Something happened to me, I'm not gonna look externally. I look internally. I'm not giving them that control over my life. I'm responsible. You would never hear me blaming someone else for my shortcomings, for my failures. You know why? Because if I'm weak in a specific area, it won't be for more. Because I'm going to keep doing it. Consistency. Consistency. I'm going to practice it again and again and again and again until I turn that weakness into a strength. See, winners feel like we are actually in control of our destiny and don't let others decide our destiny for us. Just because I fall down does not make me a failure. See, weak people, they go after things that they already know how to accomplish. Those are weak people right there. That's a weak person. But the winner, the one with the warrior mentality, he pushes his something towards something that he's never accomplished before. Winners, and that's how you learn. Winners are eager to learn. Winners are always learning and are always looking for new ways to challenge themselves. They never feel like they know enough, and they truly comprehend that knowledge is not really power. See, knowledge is not enough, but it's the application of knowledge. It's applying that knowledge. Winners, positive thinking. Scripture says in Proverbs 23, verse 7, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. The heart that is talking about here is the mind, which is the core of your thinking. And if you're always thinking negative thoughts, why in the hell are you anticipating positive results? What you think, you become. You're thinking it into existence. Winners always take optimistic perspectives towards their goals, towards life, and are always trying to leverage the field in our favor. So you watch your thoughts, because why? Your thoughts, they become large, And that's when it becomes very dangerous. When you speak your thoughts, you're speaking it into existence. Watch your words, because they become your actions. Once you speak something, you're still acting on it. Watch your actions, because they become your habits. If the habit's bad, then you're developing bad habits. You watch your habits because they become your character. And that's what you become. Watch your character because it becomes your destiny. And if your character's no good, your character's dirty, guess what? You're going to be no good and dirty, and you're not going nowhere. You are a loser. And that mentality will destroy you. Understand? See, winners are hungry. Yeah, you don't have no need to brag. You go to the gym, you're not talking. A lot of people like the jaw tap. A lot of people are always working that damn jaw muscle. Shut up and do the damn work. But you want to work the damn jaw muscle. When is that humble? They're not talking. You put in the work, consistency, discipline, then your actions speak for you. Winners never let their alter ego get in the way of their success. They know what's most essential. And don't cheat a short-term mentality. See, while a winner is modest on the inside, they know that their words are confident in their ability. Winners are certain. You can't be doubtful if you want to have a warrior's mentality, if you want to be a winner. If you want to have a warrior's mentality, all doubt must go. You must have faith. You must believe. The warrior mindset don't doubt his or her actions or decisions. The warrior mindset focus on what they're going to do next. You pull the damn trigger. Don't overthink negative thoughts and stand by their actions. Do you understand? See, the warrior mindset, someone with the warrior's mindset, someone that's driven, you set goals. You set goals. The warrior mindset, a man that's driven, is goal-oriented. They decide on what they want to do, when they want to do it, and then do whatever they morally can reach. Do whatever you can do to morally reach it. Discipline. Discipline is the bridge between goals and accomplishment. Fear is the barrier between success and failure. And your fear is an intangible. You create it in your mind. In reality, it has no substance. It's akin to a shadow. So the warrior mindset, a man that's driven, a woman that's driven, focus on solution. You don't focus on the problem. When you focus on the problem, that's what you become. You're thinking it into existence. Winners, the warrior mindset, the man that's driven, focus on how to solve the problem. Don't let the past hang on to you. You work out a solution. That is how winning is done. And when that's driven, they work hard. They have that warrior mindset. They put their best effort into it and never run away from work. You do the work. You burn the midnight oil, whatever it takes. You keep doing the work. You have to be relentless. And you keep pushing forward. No matter what you face, failure is not an option. A warrior mindset is driven. You yearn for success. You can feel it burning in you. See, when someone is driven, they take action. They don't sit around too long. One that's driven, that has a warrior mindset, never refrain from action. And are always the first to start. You don't need a reminder to begin working on becoming a legend, because you're always working on it. Now, you could be average, you can settle for mediocrity or normality, which to me is death. But if you want to live a legend, you want to leave a legacy, you got to burn the oil. You got to burn the midnight oil. And when someone is driven, they listen. A man is driven, he pays attention to others, and he thinks before he speaks. The warrior mindset They don't have to have all of the answers. And they know that they need help of others to reach their goals. So they're not a wise ass. They're not a know-it-all. Most people don't listen. This is why most people can't learn how to effectively become a secure party creditor. I talk to people on the phone. I explain things to them with phone coaching. I ask them, do they have it? They say yes. They screw it up. Why? Because most people do not listen. They do not listen with the intent to understand. They listen with the intent to reply. This is why most relationships don't work out. Someone's trying to explain something to you. You're not listening with an intent to understand, to comprehend. You're listening with an intent to reply. You're thinking about what you're going to say. So you missed the message. So the reason that I'm so passionate about this is because I'm driven. And someone with a woman mindset is passionate. Someone that's driven love what they do. And I'm passionate about it. I ask people all the time, what's your passion? What's the one thing that you wanted to do, that you always wanted to do in life? You got to find out what that is. And once you do that, then you will be successful. Then you will be successful. See, you got to use that inner obsession, that burning passion to fuel you and push you forward, especially when things get tough. That's how winning is done. See, winners, someone that's driven, that you don't need to cry. Know what I said about going, following the herd in the wrong direction? It's better to stand alone, to walk alone. Don't worry about what others do. Someone that's driven, I'm very confident. They comprehend that the path to victory is sometimes a lonely one. On the road to success, you see a lot of people that try what you try and they fail. Why? Because they didn't have what it takes to push forward. They didn't have the discipline to keep pushing on. They didn't have what it takes to be driven. So, success is where you want to go. You see all kind of dead courts lying on that board of all of these people that try and are trying to discourage you. Come on, hang out with us, do this, do that. Because they don't want you to succeed. Do you understand? You gotta be able to walk alone if you wanna leave a legacy, or you could just settle for being average and then you follow what they telling you to do and you live a miserable life. See, a person that's driven is self-motivated. One that is driven, one that has a warrior mindset, is able to motivate themselves when things get tough. They keep going. They have a permanent fire inside of them. And it always burns for success. But many of you let the fire go out. You start jaw-jacking. You start talking. Work the damn jaw muscle. Do the work now. You gotta be constantly expanding from your comfort zone. That's someone that's driven. One that's driven constantly explore changes and opportunities to expand their comfort zone. See, they know that being satisfied means that you're not improving. So you always try to stay on the edge. You don't want to be comfortable. That's average. You got to push yourself beyond your comfort zone. You gotta have a strong willpower. That's driven. Someone that's driven has a strong willpower. That's a warrior's mindset. You have to be able to withstand all types of hurdles and hardships. You gotta have good self-discipline to do that. And are able to control your mind and your body. See, your body is your temple. You gotta have high self-esteem. This is the next thing I wanna say. Why do people have low self-esteem? They could be doing real good. One person comes along and say something to them, and boom, everything drops. They start to question themselves. That's self-loathing. That's low self-esteem. Can't be like that. That's not someone that's driven. That's not a warrior's mentality. You're supposed to have enough within inside of yourself to be able to withstand any kind of external thing that's trying to come in and destroy you. Because your thinking will destroy you if you're not struggling. See, a woman, a man that's driven, a woman that's driven, know what they are worth, and they feel good about themselves. I love them. I love me so much. I might run down to the damn Jesse to the peace and marry myself. That's how much I love me. I love me. Someone else doesn't do it, I'm gonna run down to the damn Justice of the Peace and marry myself. That's how much I love me. You gotta love you. Tazadaqshah, big headed. No, I love me. You gotta love you. Because in order to give love, you have to love yourself first. See, I'm self-assured. I don't need any kind of external approval to keep me steady. Understand that. I'm persistent. I'm consistent. When someone is driven, you do whatever is morally, not whatever, but whatever is morally right to achieve your goals. You don't do easy tasks. You don't easily give up. You don't let small obstacles get in your way. You push forward. You push and you push and you keep pushing until you reach your goal. That's winning. That's how winning is accomplished. And you're not afraid of failure. See, a lot of you don't want to do stuff. Check this out. Let me tell you something about men. Let me tell you something, ladies. There's a lot of men that don't approach women that they may have otherwise been good with is because they feel a failure. They fear rejecting. There's a fear of rejecting. She doesn't know you. You don't really know her. You don't know what she might be going through in her life. Because she reject you doesn't mean that, you know, given another circumstance, she would have not actually been willing to associate with you. But she might be married, might be in a committed relationship, but you fear failure. So you missed the opportunity. See, winners know that to reach success, they will have to, at one time or another, face failure. So rather than being afraid of failure, you embrace it. You embrace the failure and you learn from it. See, someone that's driven uses failure to motivate themselves to keep being driven. But understand, failure should be our teacher, not our undertaking. Understand that failure is delay. It is not defeat, it is delay. It is a temporary obstacle, not a dead end. Failure is something we can actually avoid by saying nothing, doing nothing, and being nothing. So if you're content with that, the critics are not going to bother you. But if you want to be great, if you want to be successful, you got to risk failure. You got to fall down. And you don't procrastinate. I'm gonna tell you something, man. The reason that many of you can't change your physiques, you want a nice physique, you want to work for yourself, you want to start your own business, but guess what? You procrastinate. And as long as you keep procrastinating, you're gonna look back 15, 20 years from now, and you say, damn, I should have done it then. But it's gonna be too late. Because your ability to perform that task is gonna have actually perished. So you gotta do it now. The only reality is now. Someone that's driven does not procrastinate. Stop putting things off and try to get those things done as soon as possible. See, someone that's driven, they understand the value of time. And you try to make every second of time. So stop waiting to tell that person that you love them. Stop playing semantics. Stop playing games. You gotta be focused. Someone that's driven is focused. You are always dedicated and focused towards whatever it is that you're doing. See, someone that's driven, they know multitasking is a myth. And they try to be as productive as possible. If you wanna have the warrior mindset, try to find a better way. Experiment. Don't put all your eggs in one basket. There's always better ways of doing things. So you gotta try to find out what they are. You have to do it. Look, you want to have a warrior's mind state, if you want to be successful, you have to be a warrior. You have to be a warrior. Someone that's driven, both physically, mentally, alert. They're always on the lookout for changes in their surroundings. Just think about it. Don't sleep. I don't mean don't sleep literally. I mean don't sleep on something. What's going on? You gotta stay alert. Don't sit idle like vegetables. And you're always ready to act. And someone that's driven, someone that has a warrior mindset, someone that's successful, is confident. You gotta believe in yourself. You gotta believe in your ability. You gotta believe in your talent. You gotta be comfortable in your own skin, and you embrace your strengths and your weaknesses, because you take those weaknesses, and consistency is what turns those weaknesses into strength. I'm almost done. I'm gonna tell you, if you want to be driven, if you want to be successful, if you want to have a warrior's mentality, you have to manage your time. You gotta be very productive and know how to spend your time wisely. You gotta know that life is limited and that every moment matters. You can't be wasteful. You gotta be always improving. You make personal development your priority. Make personal development your priority and always try to improve for the better. And finally, the last thing, and tell you something, if you listen to these, if you listen to this over and over, you're gonna become successful. You're gonna become someone that develops the warrior mentality. You're gonna become someone that's driven, and your life is gonna change. So the last thing I'm gonna say to you is that someone that's driven, someone that has a warrior's mentality, you run from your mistakes. You make conscious efforts to do the right things and correct your wrongs. And you learn from those experiences. See, you know that nobody's perfect, but you gotta strive to be that until you're perfect. Because the scripture said, be you perfect as your Father in heaven is perfect. So if you want to be successful, if you want to be great in life, do these things. Listen to this message, play it back. And learn to be driven. Stop making excuses. Stop making excuses. Stop jaw chatting. Because excuses will hinder you from being what the Most High created you to be. You gotta make sure that your path is aligned with what the Creator has for you. Are you in your passion? Are you working in your passion? Are you living your passion? If not, why not? Because if you're not working in your passion, if you're not living out your passion, then you're not going to be performing as good as you should have. You're not going to be performing as good as you should. Stop allowing other people to dictate to you and tell you, oh, well, I think you should be doing this. You ever do something that you're doing it simply because someone else suggested it to you, but in your heart, you know that it wasn't right, but you still do it anyway. That's not someone that's living in their passion. They're living for someone else. And guess what? If you ever separate from that person, you're going to be discontent. And you're going to be miserable. And you're going to be one of those people talking about what you should have done. What you could have done, but you didn't do it. Because you listened to someone else, and you didn't follow your passion. So you just end up the average Joe. Because whatever it is that you're supposed to do, if you do it, you're gonna do it well. And you're gonna do it better than anyone else. Because that's what you was actually designed to do. And it's always easier to do what you was actually designed to do, not what someone else wants you to do. The easiest thing to be in life is to be yourself. The most difficult thing to be in life is what someone else wants you to be. So what you have to be taken. Are you going to follow the heart in the wrong direction? Or will you walk alone? Always be that lion us running up the mountain. Never be the lion on top of the mountain because you get comfortable. Yes, you see how great fighters, remember Anderson Silva, he got comfortable. He was hungry. When he was actually, you know, fighting for the title, he was hungry. When he got comfortable, started profiler, got destroyed. Unless he lost, because some people cannot come back from a loss. They're not strong enough. Some people can't come back from a loss because they don't have a head. That loss destroys them. But you gotta be strong enough. Before, that was just a four. He should have been able to come back from it. But he got to the top and he got comfortable. They said Anderson Silva, the greatest UFC fighter of all time. But what happened? He got comfortable. Don't get comfortable. You never want to be comfortable. Always give yourself a goal higher than what you can accomplish. If you get close to something, if you set a goal, if you accomplish it, you always want to have a higher goal. Because when you reach that goal, you become comfortable, you become complacent, and then you forget why you're there. You always want to have that burning desire. You always want to have that eye of the tiger. You don't want to get comfortable. It's the same way with life, man. People get comfortable. People get in bad relationships, they get comfortable. They stay in them. They can't walk away. Why? They fear pain. They fear what's on the outside. Some people, let me tell you the number one reason why people stay in abusive relationships is because they are not content with themselves. They don't love themselves enough and they cannot admit that to themselves. So they stay in the abusive relationship. Woman could be getting beat. Guys cheating on her, and she knows it, but she stays there because she's comfortable. And then she's listening to all of the naysayers. Oh, you need to stay with him. At least he's a good man. He's paying the bills. Yeah, but he's abusing you. He's beating you. That's not love. But she stays there. She's comfortable. Same thing with guys. They stay in relationships. Women's cheating on them. They know it, but they're comfortable. They're afraid of what's on the other side. So they stay in this bad state. And people get in those places and they get stuck in life. And so they go through life being miserable. So you got people that live in the same homes. They're married, but they're like their roommates. They're sleeping in different beds. Come on, man, get your minds right, king. Get your minds right, queen. That's not love. That's you being complacent and you got comfortable in a disastrous situation. You gotta gird up your damn loins, grab your damn nuts, and walk away and be a damn man. And I'll tell you, my queen, you gotta walk away from that situation. It's not healthy. It's not healthy, and it's destroying you. Understand that. So, we gotta maintain a positive mind state, and we never want to affiliate or be around those people that try to prevent us from being what our Creator has designed us to be, because that's not love. Anyone that's trying to prevent you from being successful or for being who you are or, you know, on your calling, because if someone is destined to be on that path with you, they're going to support you. They're going to support you in every field of endeavor as long as it's morally correct. But if they're not meant to be on that path with you, you got to have to keep them to the fucking curb and keep striving. Because if you don't, you're going to be one of those people that's talking about what you could have done, what you should have done, but what you didn't do. There's so many people. I heard all the stories like that, talking about what they could have done. It's too late for that. Could have has never exist. Should have is never exist. Because the future is like a mirage. It's like an intangible, like I was talking about. It only exists in your mind. Because the only reality is right now. It's what you do right now. It will determine what you are in the future. The way you think right now will determine how you will be in the future. So get your mind right. When I say it, I'm not just saying it as some slogan to sound cool. Get your damn minds right. And when you get your mind right, everything else will follow. Everything else will follow. So yeah, I mean, I thank everybody for tuning in. I'm going to start doing more live streams on this channel, because I don't show this channel enough love. So I'm going to start doing more live streams over here, get some people from the other channel, and, you know, start doing more over here. So that's what it is. Like, share this video, like this video. Hopefully, something in this video has actually inspired you to make a change in your life. I don't just want to like educate, and I don't want to excite. I want to insight, give you insight and inspire you to change, because there's greatness in you. All of us have a gift of some kind. We just have to discover what that gift is. And to do that, you have to be disciplined. There's greatness in you. Remember that. There's greatness in you. You're unique, you're special, and you're great. You just need to discover what that greatness is, because the world needs to hear your story. The world needs to, you need to share your greatness, your voice with the world. We all have something to give, my mom.